Do you pay a fee to convert currency that you receive from your customers before you can transfer it into your account? Well, this video will show you how to record fees for exchanges and deposits into QuickBooks Desktop. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. In this second example, the payment we receive from Yuri will be directly deposited into the bank account. However, if you need to deduct an exchange fee, you need to make an intermediate step. You need to record the full payment in the undeposited funds account. Then, with the same date, record the payment as deposited in the deposit window. That will give you the chance to deduct the fee. For example, let's imagine on January 25th, we did legal service for Yuri Buri and we billed him for 10,000 rubles. Each ruble was $0.013 on this day, January 25th. On January 30th, he pays all 10,000 rubles. The ruble is only worth 0.012 of the dollar on that day. The loss is $10 on the exchange, just like we learned how to calculate in a prior video. And to add insult to injury, they also deducted a $20 fee for the currency exchange and the transfer of funds. So how do you handle this? Well, you would record the payment the same way that we learned in the prior video, except this time you would not choose bank account, you would instead choose undeposited funds. Then, immediately after recording the payment, you would open the deposit window and deduct the fee and record the net amount into your account. So first we record these two transactions. January 25th, we did legal service, 10,000 rubles, 0.013 for Yuri. From the top left, we click New, Invoice. The date is January 25th. The customer is Yuri, and the product and service is legal fees earned. The amount, 10,000 rubles. Now, the rate is very important. The rate is an even 0.013 at the moment we record this invoice. Now, we do not want to change it back on the currency list. We want to change it only in this transaction, so we click OK, and then we click Save and Close. And as you can see, accounts receivable rubles shows up for the first time as $130, and income from legal services becomes exactly the number we expected. And now let's record the payment. On January 30, the ruble was only worth 0.012 of the dollar when we got paid all 10,000 rubles. So the loss on the exchange is $10 because we calculate it just like we learned in the prior video. So what will be the result after step one, just recording the payments into undeposited funds? Well, if they paid all 10,000 rubles, then accounts receivable rubles will go down to zero. And because they were worth 120 US dollars at the moment we received them, then undeposited funds will increase by $120 and become $2,120. And the difference is a $10 loss. Now, right now, we have a $6.30 gain. But if we put in a $10 loss against a $6.30 gain, we wind up with a net loss of $3.70. And these will be the numbers just after recording the first step of receiving the payment. From the top left, we click New, Receive Payment. The date we received the payment was January 30. We received from Yuri, and you can see he has his open invoice here, and the rate on the day we received the payment was 0.012. Now, click OK and scroll down. Now, of course, we are not going to use this, even though the money has been directly deposited to Chase Bank. We have to do the intermediate step of recording it into undeposited funds. And that's because we will have to do a second step to subtract out the fee. So we acknowledge that we have received all of the 10,000 Russian rubles, but we received it in terms of US dollars. And because the day that we received it, it was at this rate, we are going to record in our QuickBooks records a change of $120 to the accounts that we discussed a moment ago. And that's how you record it. We then click Save and Close, and you can see the results after step one are exactly as what we expected. Chase Bank has increased to $2,540. Oops, excuse me. And accounts receivable in rubles went down to zero. And you'll notice exchange gain or loss has moved from $6 on the credit side to $3.70 on the debit side. And now that we've recorded that, the very last step is to deduct out the fee and acknowledge that it actually went into the bank account. Now we're recording this deposit on the same date as the received payment, so the exchange rate will be the same. The financial institution deducted 10,000 rubles for the exchange to convert the currency to dollars and then transfer it into our Chase Bank account. And the expense that they deducted, that we record for the 10,000 rubles, is an expense called exchange and transfer fees expense. And if you don't have it in your chart of accounts, you should pause the video and put it in your chart of accounts. So what will be the results after this next step? Well, the $120 will no longer be in undeposited funds. They will be moved to the bank account. So undeposited funds goes down to $2,000 and the bank account goes up to $2,648. And of course, the fee shows up as transfer fees expense in the US dollar equivalent of the 1,000 rubles that they deducted. And at this moment, that equivalent is $12. And this will be the result after the last step that we finish recording the deposit and deduct the fee. We click New, Bank Deposit, and we first change United States dollars to Russian rubles. That gives us the ability to see all of the undeposited funds that are in rubles. Now we have to make sure that both the date and the rate are exactly what they were a moment ago. 0.012 of the US dollar on the day we received the money, January 30th. Now we click the check mark in the left to acknowledge that this is what we are physically depositing into our Chase Bank. And of course, it's going to be converted into the US dollar equivalent before it's deposited. So QuickBooks knows that you're increasing your bank account by $120 because of the number of units and the rate. Now, you have to subtract out the fee. And the way to do that is to scroll down and under the word account, click for the pull down arrow. And if you did not yet put the expense, transfer fees expense, or you could even call it conversion fees expense, but you do have the ability to add that at the moment you add a transaction. So this is account type, of course, is expense. And in this case, detail type doesn't matter. You can put other business expense if you want, but the name should be either transfer fees expense or conversion fees expense or any expense you had to pay to be able to get the money into your bank account in terms of US dollars. Click Save and Close, and then it will be on the list here. And the amount should be in terms of rubles because you physically deposited rubles and what they deducted as a fee was in terms of rubles, minus 1,000. And then, of course, you have to push tab. You put it as a negative number, so it lowers the overall deposit. So you're depositing 9,000 rubles, but it won't matter because it will be in your U.S. bank account as an increase of $108. So we double check everything. We click Save and Close. And when we go back to the trial balance, the numbers are exactly as what we expected. The undeposited funds is now down to 2,000 even. Chase bank account went up to $2,648, exactly as what we expected. And the amount we paid in terms of U.S. dollars for the transfer or the exchange fee is 12 U.S. dollars.